The Two Price, Chapter 1, Page 15. The price paid for our redemption, the infinite sacrifice of our Heavenly Father in giving His Son to die for us, should give us exalted conceptions of what we may become through Christ. As the inspired Apostle John beheld the height, the depth, and the breadth of the Father's love toward the perishing race, he was filled with adoration and reverence, and, failing to find suitable language in which to express the greatness and tenderness of this love, he called upon the world to be holy. Behold, what manner of love the Father hath bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God. 1 John 3, verse 1. What a value this places upon men! Through transgression, the Son of Man becomes subject of Satan. Through faith in the atoning sacrifice of Christ, the sons of Adam may become the sons of God. By assuming human nature, Christ elevates humanity. Fallen men are placed where, through connection with Christ, they may indeed become worthy of the name sons of God. Such love is without a parallel. Children of the Heavenly King, precious promise, theme for the most profound meditation, the matchless love of God for a world that did not love Him, the thought has a subduing power upon the soul and brings the mind into captivity to the will of God. The more we study the divine character in the light of the cross, the more we see mercy, tenderness and forgiveness blended with equity and justice, and the more clearly we discern innumerable evidences of a love that is infinite and a tender pity surpassing a mother's yearning sympathy for her wayward child. Step to Christ, page 15, June 30th.